girls, I hear you've been running from the beautiful queen that you can be becoming. You can look in my palm and see the storm coming. Read the book of my life and see I'm overcoming. Just because the length of your hair ain't long, and they often criticize you for your skin tone. Wanna hold your head high, cause you a pretty woman. Get your runway stride on and keep it going. Girl, live your life.
In the midst of an already debilitating pandemic. Two lessons that we are learning from this nation, these nationwide protests, is that we need police reform and we need it now.
But we as America, we as California, we as San Diego have to look at our original sin. We have to turn away and we have to repent from that. And that is where we are right now. And until we do that, buildings will burn and we will be uncomfortable because it goes all the way back to the foundation of this country. And so it is our job and it is our opportunity to love one another. And when we love one another, we treat each other the same. Should not have to be a difference between the way a black or brown person is treated by our officers or who are here to protect and serve us. And I know that. But it shouldn't have to be a difference. It should be the same. And so we lead with love, but we lead with action too. And we'll be okay. But it's going to take all of us.
Policymakers, I believe we must commit to bring the decision-making process out of the shadows of City Hall into the public. The community must be equal partners in any decision about the use of surveillance technology. They deserve to know when and why surveillance technology is being considered and what it is truly intended to do. Between the hours of midnight and six or so, then per clinicians are not available at all, or?
Correct.
Okay. And when we make those decisions as to what divisions will have, how do we make the decisions based on what divisions will have the teams?
There is allotted, I'm going off memory here, but basically they're allotted based on calls for service. So if you have a higher number of calls for service that would necessitate a per clinician, more per clinicians will be assigned to that command.
Okay. When we come back, I would like to see what those assignments look like per division and what those calls are per division. I did also just want to reiterate the issue around the information that folks receive from the app with regard to cases being closed when they've maybe been referred, or we get a lot of feedback about the issues not actually being taken care of, even though the app says closed.
Item 600 is declaring a state of local emergency regarding COVID-19.
My biggest priority is to ensure that we are making the decisions that we can make as a local municipality based on what is being done at the federal level, the state level, the county level, because really we are the ones that are closest to the people, and we are going to have to find ways to implement whatever comes down from those levels of government. Where we will have to step up our game is the connection that we have with the people that are most impacted, whether they are renters or landlords, small businesses, whoever it is that we are trying to help, just to get that message through and point people to places that are not black holes. I'm very uncomfortable. I think 25% actually is quite a bit of funding for District 4 not to be on the list, not even for one overlay project, considering the age of our streets and the condition of the streets in District 4. So I will not be supporting this. I would like to make a motion to send the FY 2021 RMRA project list back to city staff to provide a more equitable distribution of funds.
I have some issues with a few of them. One is certainly the $1 million going to the Navigation Center. Here's the issue that I have, based on our briefing and some questions that I've presented before. We are not quite sure how successful the current relief fund that we have is for the types of businesses that oftentimes are owned by LMI folks or in LMI communities because of the qualifications that we have, of course, matched up with the federal government, because we're getting a lot of feedback from our communities that is just, it is hard to qualify for that funding. And I agree, I definitely will be supporting this today. There's just so much work for us to do around this, and we have to continue to give folks time to recover. People are still losing their job. As the eighth largest city in the nation, a nation that is dealing with the pandemic and that has affected us in so many different ways on so many different levels, to make this announcement, to make this commitment to our API community, I think it's extremely important. I also think that we also have to recognize the time that we're in right now, where the effects of the pandemic have really shown us what has been there, but what we don't like to talk about. And now we have no choice. If we're going to move forward as a nation, state, region, city, we have to talk about these things. And it is our responsibility. Morality matters, character matters, integrity matters. Thank you for your work with my community, the Olivewood seniors in Oak Park in particular. If you can recall, they came here really concerned about being evicted, and we were able to work some things out. So I do appreciate that, and that just gives a face to how important this is. My district is suffering severely with unemployment. We have at least 18% of our folks that work in the tourism industry in District 4. That industry, we don't know when that is coming back. And even if it does, we don't know how different it will be. So we are facing many unknowns. And I think the most that we can do, we should do the most that we can do.
We are in a city right now where 28% of the homelessness population is black, where we have a very, very low, limited amount of contracts that are given to black businesses at this city, where we have a pay equity study that showed us that black females that work at this city on average make 61 cents to every dollar that a white man makes here. And so we have done all of these studies. We know, if we look at them honestly, what they tell us. First, I want to say that I apologize for the hurt and pain that I caused this week. And I'm saying that in the context of the budget vote. We issued a statement that said we would be working closely to go line by line of the police department budget, which from the time I was a staffer to being an elected, I have never seen that happen. I really do appreciate the accountability. I ran on that. That is not changing. It's not going to change.
I am committed to you. I love you all. I don't care what you say. I'm here for it. I ran in it. I'm standing in it. I'm not running away from my community, from my commitment. I'm not. And if there's something that I cannot do, I will tell you. I will tell you. But if it can be done, we're going to do it.
I think that it should be a springboard for how we provide technical assistance to various businesses that may need it. And this, as we know, this pandemic has really just exacerbated the problems that we already had. And so this is us, I believe, if it passes today as a city, acknowledging that and taking a step forward in that.
I can't justify not supporting a program created to connect with these opportunity youth in an area with high unemployment during a pandemic. I think we must look at multiple pathways to create sustainable employment, especially in communities that have been impacted the most. There's no more time where that's more important than now. And after several meetings, several conversations, I found that this was really a conversation of values.
We have to apply a race equity lens in our decision making so that Black, Indigenous, and people of color are ensured equity in the city and are protected. We all have the right to that. And so that's what the hope is for this department. It's not just a commission, but it is a department, and we'll be working within the system to change it from the inside out. And I think we'll all be the better for it.
I've had raised concerns with regard to this project in the past, but I will tell you that I have seen a lot of intentionality around this issue from the Housing Commission and the service providers with the opening of the Convention Center, along with the county and other partners. And with that, I am going to support this item today based on what the level of service and the changes that I've seen in the last 6 months or so, that if it weren't for that, I wouldn't be able to support this. You know, we did have a really tough budget season, and the good side of that is that we had a lot of participation from the public, but this report really gives us, it gives me a much better understanding of how dollars are spent, and I believe will help us make very sound decisions as we move forward. As my colleague just said, this is going to be, the upcoming budget season is also going to be very tough, and we will probably be in recovery for years from COVID-19. But it is really, really good to have these types of breakdowns so that we can make the best decisions possible. My main goal from the very beginning has always been that we include community-based organizations into what we are doing with regard to law enforcement and reimagining public safety.